Today we begin a short series of videos in which we will compare some functions available both on Siemens control and on Heidenhain control. These will be several very short episodes in which we will look at individual functions and programming differences between one control and another. Let's start with today's episode, with the circular interpolation, which is kind of in the ABCs of programming. Let's talk about the ultimate circular interpolation, namely the circular interpolation with circle center. Siemens adopts a version much closer to ISO programming. In fact, we will have a G2 or G3 for defining the direction of rotation. This is followed by the coordinates of the endpoint of our circular arc, which will change depending on the working plane. So it could be X, Y, Z, X, Y, Z. Then to follow we will have I, J and K for defining the center of the circle along the X, Y and Z axes, respectively. It is defined by default incrementally, so in relation to the starting point. But in case we want to use the absolute version, just write I, J or K equals AC and in round brackets, put the coordinate of the center of the circle in absolute. Well, instead let's look at the syntax in Heidenhain clear text, where circular interpolation is defined with two separate functions. Or rather, we will have a CC for defining the center of the circle and C for programming the circular interpolation. These are two functions programmed on two distinct blocks, and obviously the center of the circle has to be put in first, and then the circular interpolation. The first major difference between the two controls is exactly this one. In fact, in Heidenhain the CC circle center is programmed separately, but more importantly it is modal, that is, as long as it does not change, there is no need to reprogram it. The second difference is the double function of the circle center. In fact, in Heidenhain the center of the circle also identifies the pole in case of polar coordinate programming, whereas in Siemens the functions G110, G111 and G112 are used. So Heidenhain's circular interpolation will have as its syntax C, obtained by pressing the corresponding button if we are on the machine, and next we will be asked for the coordinates of the endpoint of the arc, and the direction of rotation of our interpolation. Programming DR+ will perform counterclockwise circular interpolation, while DR- will perform clockwise. One last note, again to return to the comparison of numerical controls. Also in Heidenhain we have the possibility of programming the center of the circle in incremental. To do this we will simply program the CC function with the coordinates expressed incrementally, which are obtained by pressing I. So in this case we could have CCIX plus 20, IY plus 20. We began this short video by defining circular interpolation with circle center as the ultimate interpolation. Actually, the choice of one programming method over another is driven primarily by the drawing, and the programming method will have to try to respect the drawing as closely as possible. And that is also why both numerical controls provide us with various ways of programming circular interpolation. But we said that it is the ultimate circular interpolation, because it is the only circular interpolation that gives us the most guarantees. Meaning that both numerical controls perform a check between the radius created between the start point in the center, and the radius of the endpoint in the center. If the difference between these two radiuses is greater than a set value in a well-specified machine data, an alarm message will be displayed. In Heidenhain the number of this machine data is 209.01, while in Siemens it is 210.10. Well, we are done for today. Keep following us for other episodes.